Click on this face and then sketch. Make normal 2 by pressing Ctrl plus 8 key from your keyboard. Change the shade and draw a center line. Start it from this quadrant point up to this quadrant point and then draw a circle. Start it from origin, then select the circle and then this midpoint. Make their relation coincident. Select this circle and convert it for construction geometry. Now draw one more circle on this quadrant point. Define it 8 mm and then go to Features tab and apply Extruded Cut command. Now again select Circular Pattern command and drop down these options. Select Cut Extrude 1 and then select this box pattern axis. Select this circular edge. Quantity is 8, so press OK button. Save it. Now we have to assemble all these parts together, so for that press Ctrl plus N key from your keyboard and then double click on the assembly button. Close this dialog, then open the folder where you had saved all these parts. Select all these parts and then drag them into SolidWorks assembly. Right click on the elbow and then select fix. So our blade is fixed. Right click on it and select float. Now click on this cylindrical face of wicket gates and then select mate and then click on this cylindrical face of this flange. Lock the rotation and we have to reverse the direction, so flip mate alignment. Press OK button. Now select this face and then this face. Press OK button. Similarly, select this cylindrical face of wicket gates and then this cylindrical face and then press OK button. Now select this face and then this face. Press OK button. Again press OK button. Now we have to edit this wicket gates. So click on this part and then open it. Drop down these options for boss extrude 1 and then select sketch, edit it. Make normal 2 by pressing Ctrl plus 8 key from your keyboard. Delete this distance relation 1.5 and define the diameter of this circle 189.70. Press OK button and then press this button to save and exit from sketch. Now click on this face and then select sketch. Make normal 2. Draw a circle from origin. Define this diameter 174.70 mm. Select this circle and press this box or check this box for construction and press OK button. Now draw another circle on this quadrant point. Define the diameter 9 mm. Go to Features tab and select Extruded Cut command. Cut it from throughout. Press OK button. Then apply Circular Pattern command. Drop down these options and then select Cut Extrude 2. Select this box for pattern axis and then select this circular edge. Quantity is 8. Press OK button. Now save it and then go to assembly again. So now it is okay. Unhide the discharge tube by clicking on it and then show component. Also edit this flange, click on it and then open it. Drop down this option for boss extrude 1 and then edit the sketch. Make normal 2 and then delete this relation and define the diameter of this circle 189.70. Press this button to save and exit from sketch. Now edit this sketch for cut extrude 1. Delete this center line and then define the diameter of this circle 174.70. Press this button to save and exit from sketch. So now go to assembly. Now it is okay. Select the circular face and then select mate. Now select this circular face. Press OK button. Again press OK button. Now it's time to assemble the hub. So click on this cylindrical face of hub and select mate. Now select this cylindrical face. Reverse the direction and press OK button. Now select this face. And then this face. Click on this button distance and press this button for flip dimension. Type here the distance and it is 30 mm. Press OK button. Again press OK button. Now click on this discharge tube and hide it. Then select this cylindrical face and select mate. Select this cylindrical face. Flip mate alignment and do not lock rotation. Press OK button. Select this face and then this face. Select flip mate alignment and press OK button. Again press OK button. Press the space button and then select this view orientation. Adjust the degree for the blade. Right click on the hub and fix it. Close. Now adjust the degree. Again right click on the hub and make it float. Now drop down these mirror options and then click on this concentric mate of blade with the hub and edit it. Check this box, lock rotation. Press OK button. Again press OK button. As we need 4 blades, so click on this arrow below the linear component pattern and then select circular component pattern. Select the blade and then click on this box pattern axis and select this circular edge. Type here the quantity 4. Press OK button. Press the space button and then select this view orientation. We have to decrease the distance from wicket gates to hub. So for that, in the mates option, here is the distance mate. So click on it and edit it. Type here the distance 2 mm. Press OK button. Again press OK button. Now unhide the discharge tube, so click on it and then select show component. Change the colors of all parts one by one. Now we have to design the shaft. So for that, first of all we need to know the dimensions or total length of the shaft. Click on the discharge tube and then hide it. Similarly hide the wicket gates. Now simply go to sketch tab and then select smart dimensions and then press this button, reference dimension. Select this face. And this face. So total length of shaft is 241.50 mm from this point or this face to this face. So now we can easily design the shaft. So for that, start from a new part. From here, sketch on front plane. Now draw a sketch by using line command. Start it from origin. Define the total length from this point or this line up to this line. And it is